think I have lots of talents. I don't think being president would be one of them. But if I were, I would be tough on China and the deep state for sure. And that's probably why I would have a maybe 18 months as president before they probably would Kennedy me. Let's see. Kristi Noem, once again, the identity politics. I know there's a lot of fans of hers. Don't know too much about her. Senator Tom Cotton. I do like Tom Cotton. If we were to have a senator up there, I probably would prefer him over Tim Scott because he's been a fighter on lots of different issues and has been tough on China, and I think he has a good stance internationally. Senator Rand Paul, I absolutely love Senator Rand Paul. Don't know if he's got the little too... I agree with his policies a lot. I would say 85 to 90% of the time. I like that he's a principled, but I don't, once again, I don't think for president that he has that, just he doesn't have that fighter in him. He does in some ways, but I think, I just don't think he comes off as a very strong person. Donald Trump Jr., I'm not really for dynasties. And Don Jr., I like somewhat, but he's nowhere near my guy, quite honestly. A plus would be if he did run, obviously he'd have his dad there as advisor, like in the Godfather movie, for those of you who've seen it. One of the great lines is when they've got to let Tom Higgins go. He lets Tom Higgins go, and he says, "You're a great consigliere, but who would be a better consigliere than my dad?" Right. So that's kind of how I kind of, that would be a bonus, or that would be something in favor of Don Jr. if he were to run and get it, that he would have his father there advising him. Former Vice President Mike Pence, goes without saying, he is totally washed up. They say he's got like 21% in this poll. This doesn't represent, I think, the average voter in the Republican Party. I don't think they're very happy with Mike Pence. President Trump is not happy with Mike Pence and has expressed so today on an interview with Real Voice of America. And I'll get to that in a second. Senator Josh Hawley. Like him more than some of the other people on this list. Representative Dan Crenshaw, I really don't like congressmen or women for president. I prefer senators. That's just my opinion. And then also Representative Haley, or Ambassador Haley, that's at the bottom of the list. So in this way,
Hey gang, I'm just gonna go through a series of little mic checks here for myself, just to see what's going down. Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. Okay, so that looks like it's working. Now, what I've gone ahead and done is I have flipped servers again and remade my character. I couldn't get the names that I wanted, but I got this one. Close enough, right? And it's actually a pretty cool looking name. So, here is Leonidas. Or now it was really Leonidas now, right? Or maybe it is still Leonidas. I don't know. Tomato, tomato. We shall see. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Or now it was really Leonidas now, right? Or maybe it is still Leonidas. I don't know. Tomato, tomato. We shall see. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Just listening to myself. See if everything is groovy. Here we go. Just boosted. Didn't do anything else. Just boosted. Now, I'm not sure if I want to follow the directions that are given to me here on this thing. Right? This really is wanting me to do this thing right here, isn't it? Come on. We're going to try this one out. So let's get our character all set up. All the nice things. You know what? Maybe we can even look up some wise verse 4. Should really just download their software, huh? That'll be easier. Man. Sort the two right bars one above the other instead of side by side. Good. Thumbs off. Don't need no mature language filter. Lionidas is a big boy. He's a big boy. Big boy Lionidas right here. One second, guys. I gotta get me some drinks. Sorry about that, guys. I didn't even notice the starting soon face was on there still. Been really good to have artwork up there. Blocking the entire view, folks. Not a good look. Definitely. So the wife got a new piece of love for me. She got me a boom arm for my mic, which has all these little gadgets that I can attach to it. And now the mic is right up in my face. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Anyways, what am I doing here? We don't know. What we need to do is figure out what the hell it is here. Good God. This is why we need we being I. UI add-on. Need one. I need one. What do we just do? Bartender. What do you think? Bartender. White unit frames. What am I supposed to be looking for? UI. Is it under? Tooltip? No. It's not missile. It's not boss and cat. I would think it would be under its own little thing. Am I not just looking at it properly? Where? See this thing. Oh, hey, maybe we can go while we live. Oh, yeah, oh, he's not.
Damn it, Joe. He's not.
Got an itch. Ugh. The price of the mic being right up in my face.
Right up in my face, yo.
Indy Fox is unbanned. Okay, that's gross. That's enough of that. Anyways, what are we doing? Messing around. Do our talents yet? I think we were gonna try to do it something different this time, weren't we? Well, talent. BBC. See, talent calculator for the paladin. Let's see. Set something here while. Boobies on the channel. Good. Really affected. Trying to figure out how to get green in there. It's showing. It's because I happily. We also split.
Okay.
Guess we can get some proper use out of my tablet. So we can do this way. Display capture. Tablet. Okay, so that's that. Ooh.
Go. Let me look at it here. Uh-oh. Happened.
There it is. There it is.
Yeah, I know. Every time that I do it, I audio simply because I'm getting gray. It's okay. Okay. It's all right. It'll be fine here. Okay. Checking in. This is all good. Right? Audio is back. Let's fix that so that way we always have audio on. Sound in the background. Okay. So, let's check if our we want to increase our always also want reduce the cooldown of your blessing or protection by 6 seconds, increase speed down. We like absorption. Yeah, we like absorption. Right? But we're gonna go without for now. Just for now. Let's see. Don't really care. So we're going to try to focus on Lionidas being an AoE farmer right off the bat. I know there's a guide for that on YouTube. Paladin AoE. think it was Metagoblin that did it.
She has eluded your soldiers for 19 days.
She's public enemy number one in Gilead.
I'm gonna find her. I'm gonna kill her.
Skip that sucker.
Alright guys, and welcome to another video. Today I'm presenting to you my Paladin 60 to 70 leveling guide for Classic or Legacy TBC. This video will cover a number of very important topics. Firstly, unique to this guide, we're going to have a little bit of an introduction section because there's an important issue we need to get out of the way when it comes to Paladin leveling, you know, before we even get into the meat of the video. Secondly, unique tips and tricks. Thirdly, optimal leveling talents. Optimal playstyle for kill time and mana efficiency, stat priority, useful classic WoW items and trinkets to keep, and lastly we'll finish off talking about reputation priority. So the biggest question that people ask when they want to level a paladin in the Burning Crusade is, should I level in ret spec or protection spec? Normally I would recommend retribution, but since many paladins from classic WoW are running around in silly hats and dresses, you know, because I've been a healer for the past 2 years, many paladins will have a lot of spell power, MP5 gear, and very That's likely true. To have a shield, which makes a protection paladin very viable since the majority of its damage relies on spell power coefficients. As a prop paladin with good spell power, we can easily take down 2 to 4 mobs, whereas a ret paladin will probably struggle with about 2 mobs. So even though you may be glugging more water, it's still worth it in the long run, because it's just going to be way more efficient, you know. Especially since there's going to be competition to actually get mob tags in the first place, and a protection paladin can be very cheeky and steal 4 mob tags at once. But we'll talk more about that in the playstyle section. For now, we're going to run into some important tips and tricks that paladins should actually be applying now, meaning the second you stop watching this video, in order to prepare for the launch of TBC. Tip number one, get Avengers gear and Judgment gear. So these two sets are basically going to be best in slot for paladin leveling. This is because it provides a decent amount of strength, spell power damage, rather than just healing power. Because if you look at tier 3 gear, it only provides healing power, and then it has no strength on it, right? Which totally sucks for solo content. If you want to be getting Avengers gear, filling in a few pieces that you can get with Vengeance gear with Judgment gear, because that will provide the best stats. So essentially, you want to be hybridizing strength gear and spell power and MP5 gear. My second tip is you need to get yourself a powerful spell power main hand weapon and also a decent two-handed weapon. You're going to need a lot of spell power when for your tanking, such as, you know, you can get Mage Blade, you can get Lock and Myrrh. Obviously, I understand that you may not have obtained those items yet from farming raids, in which case you can get the Master Smith's Hammer from Upper Blackrock Spire or the Lightforged Blade from the Sunken Temple class quests. And make sure to get the Spell Power enchantment on them and get yourself some brilliant Wizard Oil. Spell Power weapons will increase the damage of Consecration and Holy Shield massively. And you want to bring a two-handed weapon for whenever you are dealing with a single enemy, because that's just simply better than having a one-handed and a shield. So get rolling on these, you know, big two-handed weapons that normally just get disenchanted during raid farming, because, you know, you are going to actually get some use out of them. Such as Dark Edge of Insanity, although that one probably won't be disenchanted. And, you know, the Untamed Blade, or you can even go for the effort of crafting Sulphur Ass if you really want to, you know, but that obviously costs a lot of time and money. An easier option would be to get the Arcanite Reaper or the Unstoppable Force from the Alteric Valley rep grind, because, you know, the reason why a two-handed weapon is going to be so useful is because it's going to have good interactions with the Reckoning talent. When that procs, you're going to get double weapon swings on a big two-handed weapon, so that's going to be really, really good and do insane damage. Thirdly, you need to be downranking your spells. I'll talk more about this later in the playstyle section, but you should be adapting the ranks of your spells in accordance with your mana efficiency, you know, based on your current gear, to find a kind of good sweet spot. Remember that you can use Blessing of Protection and a Holy Wrath combo to deal insane AoE damage to demons and undead, so be sure to take advantage of it, and obviously you can also use Divine Shield. Just make sure to never cast Holy Wrath when you get melee, because you take loads of damage because you have no avoidance when you're casting, and it would probably take ages to actually get that cast off. And my last tip is to get a Thorium Shield Spike for a little extra damage on your blocks. There are out of items out there that you can get. Recommend checking out more advanced guides like AoE Paladin guides, because there are some gimmicky items that you can get, like the Skull Flame Shield, which does actually scale with spell power, which is pretty decent. So let's take a little look at the optimal talent order. So now I'll be specking into protection with a few points in home. So first of all, you're going to get Rebout. Simply is better than Devotion or a by a country mile. You can have a proc that essentially allows you to get a little bit extra block chance, which does stack up Holy Shield, which is really nice. Then we're going to get Guardian's Favour, because we'll be using Blessing Protection from time to time, again, like I said before, with a Holy Wrath combo, which is actually pretty useful to get a little bit of extra damage in your AoE rotation. We'll obviously talk about that even more later. And then from here, you want Precision for the increased hit chance. A lot of paladins aren't going to have hit chance on their gear because they're in healer gear, so we will need a little bit of hit chance. That's definitely going to come in useful. Then from here, you just want Shield Specialization, a little bit of extra damage reduction. You can't complain. We're going to max out Improved Righteous Fury for a little bit of flat damage reduction, which is really nice. And then from here, you may want to get, well, you may think you want to get Toughness and Anticipation. Toughness doesn't actually equate to that much damage reduction. It's not that great, unfortunately. And then Anticipation, you don't want, because you actually don't want that much avoidance when you're doing solo content as a prop paladin, because then Reckoning won't proc. Reckoning will have a lower chance to actually proc.
Wait, what?
So, actually equate to that much damage reduction, it's not that great, unfortunately. And then Anticipation, you don't want, because you actually don't want that much avoidance when you're doing solo content as a prop paladin, because then Reckoning won't proc. Reckoning will have a lower chance to actually proc, so then you won't get the damage benefit of having Reckoning. So that's why you avoid that talent. You're going to get improved Hammer of Justice. Pretty straightforward. You're going to be able to use Hammer of Justice a little bit more. Really can't complain. And then from here, I like to get 1 point in Blessing of Kings, because you'd never want to be that guy who is in a group, people are asking for kings, and then you don't have it, because it's awkward and it makes you look like a bad paladin. When you want to max out Reckoning, get Blessing of Sanctuary. And then from here, you want to max out One-Handed Weapon Specialization. We're also going to get Reckoning. I'll talk about that more a bit later, because it's basically a massive...
What about Blessing of Freedom?
Effect. You have a chance that when you take damage, you will get an extra...
Honestly...
four times, which is why you ideally want a fast weapon to fully benefit from the buff. So that is a map.
What does it say about that?
Then from here, I like to get 1 point in Blessing of Kings, because you'd never have hit chance on their gear. Then we're going to get Guardian's Favour, because we'll be using Blessing Protection from time to time, again, like I said before, with a Holy Wrath combo, which is actually pretty useful to get a little bit of extra damage in your AoE rotation. We'll obviously talk about that even more later. And then from here, you want Precision for the increased hit chance. A lot of paladins aren't going to have hit chance on their gear because they're in healer gear, so we will need a little bit of hit chance. That's definitely going to come in useful. Then from here, you just want Shield Specialization, a little bit of extra damage reduction, really cannot complain. We're going to max out Improved Righteous Fury for a little bit of flat damage reduction, which is really nice. And then from here, you may think you want to get Toughness and Anticipation. Toughness doesn't actually equate to that much damage reduction. It's not that great, unfortunately. And then Anticipation, you don't want, because you actually don't want that much avoidance when you're doing solo content as a prop paladin, because then Reckoning won't proc. Reckoning will have a lower chance to actually proc, so then you won't get the damage benefit of having Reckoning. So that's why you avoid that talent. When you get improved Hammer of Justice, pretty straightforward. You're going to be able to use Hammer of Justice a little bit more. You really can't complain. And then from here, I like to get 1 point in Blessing of Kings, because you'd never want to be that guy who is in a group, people are asking for kings, and then you don't have it, because it's awkward and it makes you look like a...
That's very true.
When you want to max out Reckoning...
Sorry, got it.
Get Blessing of Sanctuary, and then from here, you want to max out One-Handed Weapon Specialization. We're obviously going to get Reckoning. I'll talk about that more a bit later, because it's basically a massive damage-increasing effect. You have a chance that when you take damage, you will get an extra weapon swing. Well, it can happen four times, which is why you ideally want a fast weapon to fully benefit from the buff. So that is a massive damage increase, particularly with a two-handed weapon too. Then we have his next talent, One-Handed Weapon Specialization. Now, I didn't realize this, but when I first looked at this talent, I thought, oh, that just increases my damage from the main hand. But if you read it, it says increases all damage you deal when a one-handed weapon is equipped by 5%. So that increases all your damage. every single thing you do in this game, the damage is increased by 5%, so that you really cannot complain at that. Then obviously you want Holy Shield, pretty essential ability for a protection paladin, but you only want 1 point in improved Holy Shield, because what you'll find is that you will not fully benefit from the charges before Holy Shield buff actually totally falls off. So you very rarely see anyone even use 2 points to improve Holy Shield.
Oh, no sacred.
Insanely big dungeon pulls and things like that. Then you want to max out Ardent Defender, because you're doing solo content, you will drop below 35% health. You will actually see more benefit from this talent, which you don't see by watching raids. It's because you're always topped up above 50% health. So this is actually really useful for when you're doing solo content. And then from here we get 2 points in Sacred Duty. The literally only reason why is because it's going to provide better stamina scaling than combat expertise, because a point for point basis,
yeah, about the same.
That is 2%, this is 3%. And then you obviously get that nice buff to Divine Shield, which you will use from time to time. Then you want to get Avenger Shield, and we want to dip automatically, pretty sure, yeah, if we're level 50 now, we definitely want to dip over to the Holy Tree to get max out Divine Strength, because it's, you can go for the Divine Intellect one if you really want, but I just prefer Divine Strength. Strength is actually a pretty useless talent for a protection paladin, but again, you probably will need it because you may not have a lot of strength if your deck's out with like healing gear and stuff like that. But anyway, we have Spiritual Focus, simply by the fact that just you can totally cheese heals whenever you're taking melee damage. It just makes healing much, much easier, and it really helps to actually keep you alive if you're in a dire situation and you need to pop off a Holy Light. Then this will stop you from, you know, stop the cast from taking ages. Particularly when you combine it with Concentration Aura, then you have zero damage interruption caused on the cast, which is pretty Bob's your uncle. Then you are officially level 60, and from here you have choices. You know, if you're on a PvP...
I'm going to stop right there, buddy. Oh shit, hell yeah. I had more. All right, let's turn off the screen. Stream is. Balls. All these names don't help out either, does it? Everybody's names. Okay, so I need to go over here, it looks like. see. Gave me some good loot. Want supply? No, I don't want to. What do we do now? Gosh, dang it. Yay, useless items, because I already got stuff, right? For the most part. Good sword with stamina. Okay. Do the shield block there. That increases the block rate by 5. So it's got spirit, though. Only has strength. Next. What? We'll just do that. Keep that. Stuff that we want to keep in there. That is a relic. Relic. Do that one, I guess. Trinket. A chance to get stuck in combat or increase armor by 15. That one on. First 200, we don't care about that really. Right now. Go. Actually, that might be. So this stuff can go somewhere. Not now. Get on that mail. Is this the Titan again? Yep. Yep, yep. This stuff back in the bank.
What can I do for you?
My current relic now. There's no other relics in here, right? That's a trinket. this one. Probably don't want to bring this. Extra heal, that's actually pretty nice. Damage and heal, that's actually pretty nice. Backpack. I'm gonna on to.
Go with honor, friend.
Handy. If it can come in handy! Okay, so got that done, and then now what? This tells us to get a spell by speaking to a paladin trainer. Okay. We're trying to spell. Seriously.
For the Alliance.
Grant a spell. Wait.
Light be with you.
What are these? This. You know, or I'll keep the books. That's pretty neat. Repeatable. Maybe
Light be with you.
Maybe later I'll do something else with it. Hey, she gave me 3 gold. Activate the talents interface and allocate 5 talent points. Okay, thank you. Woohoo.
Farewell.
You get scared there.
Where do I get that bitter at? Here? Okay, so I still need to go down here anyways, right? So, with the blasted lens. Into the blasted lens. Going to the blasted lens. Yeah, I am. Heading to the blasted lands. I'll do the bag non as well. So this thing is telling me to get the Nether Guard bitter. That is what we will do. Hold it in your inventory for a few net levels. Stairs.
Where the frick are you, buddy? Tar Bernie. What a spot. Bernie. Get buddy. Get home slice. Oh, there you are.
Looking for something specific?
Better. Better.
See you later.
Using my wife's mouse because her hand's been hurting. I wanted to test it out. She's using mine and she says that her hand hasn't been hurting. And I've been telling her that mine is actually cramping. So, this kind of sucks. I also don't want to change any of the settings on it. So that's why I'm kind of waiting to put anything on the keyboard. Just doing this initial quest to get this stuff started, but I'm not going to be leveling over there first. We're going to be taking care of some Eastern Plague Lands. Alright, train's coming through. Choo-choo, chugga-chugga-chugga. It's like a little train stop here. And there's a whole bunch of Silithia stuff still that I want to take care of. A lot of quests over there still. Excuse me.
Well met. Be careful.
Bye, guys.
What can I do for you?
What can I do for you?
think this spike's gonna work a little bit better.
Let's see.
Need help? Safe travels. Well met. Be careful.
Need help? For the Alliance.
Sid Lombardi. That's pretty badass.
Greetings. Light bless you.
And force. Up this way. I was playing this the first time. I was playing it with five characters at once. Paladins, I think they were.
Need help? Go with honor, friend. Greetings.
Multi-boxing is fun. Using it, you know. Fortunately, there are people that abuse anything. So, but what ifs? Okay. I don't know why I'm picking these up. Okay, we'll go ahead and dump them. Sure I am. Do that. Out here.
You got my attention. Off with you.
Need help? Be careful.
Eastern, Western. Let's not say that. Good advice. Let's just say. Interesting. Thank you. To just stay here, so I will just go ahead and grab all of the wrap. Well, see, the thing is they're all yellow, man. So when I say dungeon spam, pretty nice guy, Scar of Westfall. Sarah. These Twisted Misfits. Who? Twisted Misfits. Who? Twisted. Many folks. Second. All right, I am back. I guess I need to go to
Hey there. What's on your mind? Be good.
I guess I couldn't get on the bird while I was running.
Here for the winter to be with you, and it's like you're not even here with us.
Good.
can't. What do you mean you can't pull your mount out right here? Missed my turn. Missed my turn. That's gonna get annoying.
These days, there is a lot to balance. When Grammarly ensures you communicate at your best, wherever...
Hey guys, Dev here. Submitting in heaps of questions about my add-ons recently. So today we're going to be covering my top 5 favorite add-ons for my Prop Paladin, Classic WoW TBC. Before we get into it though, if you do find anything useful or informative in this video, feel free to give me a subscription. We're getting awfully close to 5k now, which is absolutely amazing.
Can't awfully think close. Enough.
And the other people that I want to give an extra special shout out is my awesome Patreons. There's a Patreon link in the description if you feel like supporting the channel like that. But thank you to you guys. You guys are amazing, and we're getting really close to getting me a new hard drive, which will help store more videos for the channel. And as you guys know, I hate long intros, so let's get straight into the information. And here is number 5.
Although he gave one,
right? So the first item we're going to take a look at is Details. And Details has a great damage meter and healing meter, but as a touching, you know, if they're... You can position it to open class, and it basically click on your interface, and to switch it into the threat meter, you click on the cog and come into plugins raid, tiny threat, and that will give you a threat meter, and then you can lock it in place so you don't accidentally drag it around. Number 4. So the next add-on we're going to take a look at is Pally Power, guys. So Pally Power is a really powerful add-on, and it basically allows you to assign blessings throughout your raid. Now, B. Um, obviously not working now because it's trying to buff Beauty. He's out of range. But it'll show there's one paladin missing, Kings, which is Beauty, because obviously he's not here. That tracks next useful heads up at display for our videos. So WeCore is basically a way to provide a heads up at display for certain things that you need to track on your today is WeCore. Okay, so the is number three. Okay, so the third add-on we're checking out today is WeCorers, and you guys know I've already done a bunch of WeCorer videos. So WeCorers is basically a way to provide a heads-up display for certain things that you need to track on your interface. So this can be useful for boss mechanics, useful for personal cooldowns and stuff like that. So in one of my videos, I've given away my WeCorers here that tracks Holy Shield, Judgment cooldown, and it also tracks what's on the boss. It just makes it a lot easier to have it here, where your eyes are, in the middle of your screen, where the boss is, where the action's happening, rather than trying to scan your buff line in the middle of a raid to check, you know, the Seal of Righteousness. I couldn't play without my buffs, especially as a paladin. You've got lots of seals coming in, getting judged onto the mob, and then the next one starts. So lots to see it shows if you don't have anything active right now. So this is super handy for me. You can grab that in my other video open where I give this away and fully explain how it works down below. I've also done a video here on the crush cap calculator, which is another great WeCorer that I use. So there'll be a link to that in the description as well if you want to go check that out at the end of this video. But WeCorers are basically a link to the power of what you can track on screen. If you don't have them, it's kind of like you're playing blind, so this is definitely something I'd pick up sooner rather than later. Number two. Okay, so my second favorite add-on in Classic WoW is Item Rack. And what Item Rack does is, firstly, it gives us the option to come in and switch a piece of gear out from the middle of the bat, which shows all the legs we have in our bags. So that's super handy. It also facilitates gear swapping from the bank as well. It shows what's in your inventory, what's in your bank when you have your bank window open. However, what most people use Item Rack for is its set management, its wardrobe function. So in Classic WoW, I had about 15 different sets that I'd use for different things. PvP Holy, Mitigation Block, Spell Power Balanced, all of that kind of stuff. Eventually, I'm going to build that out in TBC. Right now, I just have my Mitigation, my Spell Power set. So you can see there's quite a few different gear pieces that switch around between these two sets. And you can either keybind those sets, or what I do here, I make a macro. So Item Rack, Equip, Mitigation, and obviously I've got one for spell power, and I just put these buttons down here on my bar. So if I need to go and tank, say, another dungeon, I just want to have heaps of spell power gear on so we can just blast it out, heaps of damage, heaps of threat, click of a button, and I made my spell power set. It's literally that easy. So that was Item Rack, super useful add-on. Hey guys, Nighttime Dev, and I forgot to record the number one add-on. So I'm doing it now while I'm editing the video. So we're going to talk about Plater really quickly. Plater is by far my favorite add-on in the entire game. It is so good for tanking and so good for prop paladin. So I've just got some footage here from our Heroic Shattered Halls run, and I'm going to show you exactly how Plater works. So from the pause screen here, I can see the boss's health. I can see the noticeable buffs that I need to know about. So Sweeping Strikes is on the boss, 9 seconds remain with 5 charges. You can also see my Seal of Wisdom on that target. And the color of the boss is this nice blue color. Now you see that it's just changed to a yellow color. That means that someone's getting close to me on threat. And if you check the threat meter, that's letting me know that mob has low threat, right? So I need to put some more attention into that mob quickly, and I've just pulled out of the range there, the warning, basically. The warning threshold. So now, as the boss has charged off, you see he's still, his nameplate is still blue, so that's letting me know that he hasn't dropped threat, I still have threat, and he's going to come back to me. The sharpshooter guard that's coming in, so he's got a red nameplate, and what that's letting me know there is I don't have threat on this target, right? And I can see him, he's running past, no threat, and what do? I hit him with a hodge. I can see the hodge on him, just purely off his nameplate. He's got 5 seconds left on that hodge, and as that ticks down, I know I've got 1 second. I'm going to have to make a threat soon. I get a const underneath him. And then I pull it back onto him. When he's back on me, his nameplate changes to blue. So basically, this just shows you how it works. Obviously, this is a short sample of one boss fight. But when you're tanking big packs and you know, you've got DPS all over the shop, they may not be following your kill markers or whatever, it shows you what you need to spend time generating threat on before you lose threat. So heaps of people have asked me about this. Plater is by far one of the strongest add-ons available. It will change your tanking game. So if you only get one add-on from this video today, go and get Plater. So that's my five favorite add-ons, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy the video, please hit that sub button. It goes a really long way, and my Discord and Patreon links are in the description if you want to come join, and I'll see you in the next one.
Get moving with the Planet Fitness Black Card and check out all the perks for zero enrollment, $22.99 a month, now through June 16th. Like at...
Later. Sucker. Last updated 10 hours ago. There is a nameplate add-on. That ain't you. The deep tracking. Shit. Download that and we'll see. Later on. I guess you get LVY over there. Derp. Derp. Derp da derp. Thank you. Oh, you can only have one, huh? Okay, my bad. I thought it was one of both. Or one of both. You can have both on. My bad. So many blessings. Divine intervention is when I killed myself to have somebody else survive. That's what that is. Business already beaten on me. See, I totally forgot that I'm supposed to be keeping my eyes out for this. It's a cop of pain right there. All right. Open that up. I need this. Order of Justice. Instant cast. So this is Blessing of Kings. This is up there. Where? So this one's up there. Okay. I need this as my taunt. These are actually I can just those rounds, so bindings, action bar. There's that top section there. These, so mouse button 4. Yeah, I don't know. It's this one. Button 4. Mouse button 4. Weird. Alright, we don't want that. Special action, special action. Multi action. Bottom left. Aren't bound. She does not have those bound. Let's see if we can fix that for her. Oh, I guess it's mine now, right? I guess it's mine now. Well, up at all. I'm set up really weird too. Got everything. 5. With that.
Alt. What does that look like? Well, move these off real quick. What's going on? You're not on that one? Not on our profile 4? Where is... Was working, wasn't it? Let's check again. Yes, find a multi. Oh, it's not in there. Guys, I mouse. My wife took mine. I was gonna need to do this, but apparently I'm gonna need to do that because mine has been taken, which is okay. I'm gonna keep playing, so great. Come on, it's not gonna do any of it.
I just set it up. What is the loop? It'll all work now, right? Punch over there. Raid, right? No. But this is plus 10% stats, yeah. This one. I don't want that thing. You know what? Thing there. That cleanse thing here. Okay. So we want to put this there. Let's see. What about our seals? Seal of Wisdom. Tail of light. I think this is. So, fills the problem with a divine light for 30 seconds, giving each melee strike a chance to heal. Unleashing the seal will judge the enemy for 20 seconds, granting any melee attack, judge the enemy a chance to heal the attacker. If your melee strikes were fresh. Okay, so this is just a heal, and smacking it on somebody doesn't do extra damage. I think the only one that does extra damage is this one, right? Fills the paladin up, unleashing the seal of energy will cause that damage to go through. Turn undead out for a while. Now. Heals a friendly target for 1,266 for 580. Yeah. Put that out there somewhere for now. I know Exorcism is an instant cast. So that's awesome. Put here this one for now right there. Already got my blessings. No. Okay. Blessing of light there. So many things to look at. So what's the difference between cleanse and purify? So purify is a friendly target, removing one disease effect and one poison effect. It's 87 mana and instant cast. Cleanse is a friendly target, removing one poison effect, one disease effect, and one magic effect. So one poison, one disease, one magic. One disease, poison. Yep. What do you think? Holy wrath. So I don't think I need anything else here. What's that seal of light? There. Somewhere. Yep. There. Okay, I got everything this side. No, I need my holy shield out. Up out. Right. 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 Nope. have to get water. My bad. Bad. Okay. Meal of Justice. Pushing the steel of energy will prevent them from being. Gotta set these up to be on controls and shit. Got the protection out. So now we gotta fix this part here. We're gonna hold on to that for now there, but we need to move other stuff around. I think this goes there. This does no damage. This does no damage. This is the only one that does damage. Does no damage. There isn't any. Oh, there's this another seal here. I forgot. Crusader seal. Does damage. Blessing of Kings. There's a greater blessing of wisdom somewhere around here too that I saw. Is it just one? Yeah. I think it's only one judgment, right? There isn't a blue judgment anywhere. Pretty sure I remember a blue one way back when. Wasn't there? Wasn't there a blue judge thing, Majiggy, that Paladins used to have? No. Okay. So. Here, turn on. We are gonna kill shit. Our blessing things. And let's go. Ah, bitches. It's my mind.
Burn!
Why do I have that on? What's that bat on? Back, I guess.
Ain't scared of you, fat man.
I am not scared of you, fat man. blue leather bag. Give me back. Hold me back. Come back, guys. Lot better. Definitely worked a lot better. Oh, you little bitches. It would be better to keep this instead. Probably gonna fuck over that drink. Man. Seriously? Thank you. better blow shit up, I think. Seriously? More mana. It. The shitty room. Robots. I need my whole, oh my god, stay on hand. Jeez Louise. mana. I'm just doing this to collect some resources. I need to level up this guy's low level disenchanting stuff, and maybe this is a good way to get that shit. Learn my buttons. That's all. That's all I'm doing. Avenger shield back. I gotta go get the gunpowder. Totally forgot about that. Totally forgot about the gunpowder, yo. The gunpowder. Yeah, that shit. Oh, look. Fuckers.
Check out that noise. We're under attack! Avast, you swabs! Repel the invaders!
Where are you going now? Crazy ass. How many greens this time around? It's Mighty Hammer. A nice one. That's a nice one. Want a drink? I'm gonna pull this one over here. These guys. Guys, or what? They're gonna kill me. Come on, buddy. Let's get that shit going here. Cookie stirring rod. And I just, oh, my inventory is full, so. B. Get rid of this crap. Armor is usually the lowest coin that you can get. And we're just doing this because we are gathering linen and wool for the wife. Collecting greens. Enchanting. A little bit. Drink. Gotta set up the rest of my buttons. They're all over the place still. Those guys up after me. Get that parrot. There and get that boss. Watch. Okay, boss, there's an asshole over here.
some butthead killing us. We need help, boss.
Come on. I don't even think I hit him. Hit me and then he died.
Oh, man, that hurts.
You need those rocks, but I don't need that cheese. Deloran sharp. Don't need the crap. And there's a box over here. There. Get this here. Prepare for that. We want that. What else can we throw away? What else can we? Want the rough stone. We don't need that ice cold milk. Even though it does a paladin's body good, don't need it. And this is the last group, so we're just gonna go ahead and hey guys. Don't mind me. That's the crew. Guys, relax. Relax, guys. Relax, guys. So, we get here. Let's enchant the stuff that we picked up. Green. We can. We could probably make more money selling the greens on the auction house, but we also need to level up our bills without spending any money over there in the auction house. Ay, ay, ay. That there. I think I can get that yet, can I? Nope. But these are all blues. Got a long ways to go. I think these require 25, right? Yeah, 25, yeah. Long ways to go. Get there, though. Only on 10, so 15 points. I think. Thank you. so I don't disenchant any of that stuff. It's all my shit. Can't do that one yet. If that is too high of a level for me. Here's a 10. Always gotta leave a goblin behind. Alive. Perpetuate the species. Can't just kill them all. As for these miners, we can always pick up miners. Random village. Coming from all over the place right now, or what's going on? What are you doing? Where you going, buddy? Hey, bud. Hey, bud. What's up, man? What's up, man? What's up, man? What's up, man? How you doing? Oh, so you want to hit me? You want to hit me now? All right, you can hit me. You hit me. Come over here and hit me. I'll let you. Oh, that hurt. Oh. You're gonna die. You're gonna hurt yourself. You're gonna hurt yourself, yo. You're gonna hurt yourself. You don't wanna hurt yourself. Told you. Told him. Y'all saw. Heard, anyways. Oop. I wonder if we can... Stuff. Whole bunch of space. Okay. Here. There needs to be a button that just says, oh, you want to leave the incense? Here you go. Leave the incense. That wouldn't be classic, would it? I was pretty surprised to find myself looking for a looking for tab button. Earlier. Nope. It's new school. The old school over here. What's that over there? What's that? This way. Oh. This is where that random boss spawns. All these tin veins. Look at that. Hey, look. Promo pose. Oh, flame striking it. Oh. What's up, man? Killed the guy. Look just like you, broski. Oop. Oh, he had a Buccaneers bracers of the eagle. Like it. Yeah, dang it. Where we go? Go. Boom. Oh.
Did I not get all of it? Man, I'm so retarded sometimes. Late. That's my excuse. It's late.
Late. Later than. Later than late.
Going up 3 hours so far. 2.5. 30-minute start time. I am actually going to log for the night, guys. Hopefully you all enjoyed. If you did, like, share, subscribe. Peace out, guys. Rude Jude and Linitis signing out.